So this section is all about siege warfare, which in the medieval period meant castles. Castles started off really basic and the defences massively built up. The methods of attack were sometimes really ingenious, really clever, but they were always slow burners for the most part anyway. It very rarely came to an actual attack, but in this podcast we're going to have a little look at the ways these castles were attacked and also look at how gunpowder had an impact on siege warfare. So without further ado, let's get cracking with William I and Motton Bailey Castles.
I'm headed straight for the castle. They wanna make me their queen. There's an old man sitting on the throne there, saying that I probably shouldn't be so mean. I'm headed straight for the castle. They've got the kingdom locked up. There's an old man sitting on the throne there, saying I should probably keep my pretty mouth shut. Straight for the castle.
Oh, all these minutes passing, sick of feeling used. If you wanna break these walls down, you're gonna get bruised. Now my neck is open wide, begging for a fist around it. Already choking on my pride, so there's no use crying.
I'm headed straight for the castle. They wanna make me their queen. And there's an old man sitting on the throne there, saying that I probably shouldn't be so mean. I'm headed straight for the castle. They've got the kingdom locked up. And there's an old man sitting on the throne there, saying I should probably keep my pretty mouth shut.
If an attacking force decided to attack a castle, there was kind of four stages to go through. The first stage was encirclement. Surround the castle, make sure nobody can get in, nobody can get out, and no supplies can get in or out. And then, sometimes, wait. See what happens. See if the enemy surrender or come out to negotiate. So part one is encirclement. Part two would be battery. There's no point in waiting around forever. Even if you don't go for an all-out attack, you may as well start to try to weaken the enemy defences. Perhaps you could send a battering ram to start battering down the gate or one of the walls. Or a bit of a slow burner, in this case, which was quite popular, would be to dig a mine under the castle walls. And then when the tunnel had been built underneath the walls, he set fire to the wooden structures that was holding up the mine, and the tunnel had collapsed, and hopefully the wall would collapse into the gap that he'd made. So, that second stage, battery. Then, he'd hopefully come to negotiation, where the attackers and the defenders would negotiate a surrender, or sometimes the defenders might pay the attackers to go away, or at least pay them to not slaughter everybody if they managed to get inside. But negotiations didn't always work, and in some very rare occasions, an attack had to happen on some rare occasions. So the attackers would then use all of their weaponry at their disposal and all the tactics and all the ideas they had to try to get into the castle. And siege warfare was quite often a small force defending and a large force attacking. But it didn't often get to this because sieges usually lasted so long that the attackers maybe ran out of food themselves, or maybe the defenders had some friends somewhere else who were coming to reinforce them to break the siege. So it didn't often get to that attacking stage.